Tell your neighbor, thank you for being here today. I take this time to, first of all, just to thank the Lord for this opportunity to be here to share the Word of God. The Bible says the Word of God is a lamp to my feet and a light to my path. And secondly, I take this time to thank the principal and the leaders of the school, vice principal or assistant principal, and all the teachers. And also, I share it in other school. Then when we come to Sila, I think twice we came here and I see teachers sit around. It does not happen like that in other school. Hallelujah. Other school teachers like they are not part of the program. And sometimes that is the problem. When we are not part of a program, when everybody supposed to be part of the program. Because the Word of God is the Word of God. Plants die, flowers wither, but the Word of God remains forever. So I take this time to thank the teachers and the leaders of the school for opportunities like this. When we come, I think this is the third time, first time in the one hall down there, and here, in the hard court here, this is the second time. And the second time, I see the teachers sit around and they listen. So I take this time to thank you, teachers. Okay, student, give a hand clap to the teachers for being attentive to this program. And I believe that we are all part and parcel. I was, as I said before, I was in a committee that they talk about Crime Stoppers. And that was the first time I attended that meeting because I come from the MyTV, which aired every Sunday evening, the Crime Stoppers. If you watch the television, you'll see it come out on a Sunday evening. And because we also own the television station, I went to the meeting just to sit there and listen. And there's a big problem in Fiji. The criminal activities is so high. Sometimes everything looks nice on the surface. But when you sit there and you listen to the record of stealing, home invasion, robberies with violence, grab and run, pickpocket, you amazed of the criminal activities that we have. It's always on the increase. So I sat there and said, Lord, if they're talking about increase in the sentence or maybe increase the years they will spend in prison, it's really not the answer. Because you throw in the men to prison, and who will suffer? The family. If married, then the wife, the children. If a young man, oh, what a waste to spend 10 years in prison when he's supposed to be educated. There must be some other way. The Lord spoke into my heart. You go to principal, and you go to the permanent secretaries, and ask them to visit school and share the word of God. And which we did. And that's why we're here today, visiting secondary school, that we believe that the word of God can also, if not the only message or solution to the problem that we're facing. Because we are dealing with criminals, we are not dealing with men, we are dealing with the demons, tomorrow. It's anything that evil comes from the devil. But we are arresting the men. We take the men, throw them into prison. But the devil will jump to another one. Can you get what I'm saying? If men is the cause of all this, we arrest all the thieves and finish. But because it's a spirit, it's a war in the spirit. Yeah? So when you arrest that man, the spirit comes out when you throw them to Corvo and jump to another person. That's why Paul said, you are not fighting flesh and blood. You are fighting powers and principalities. See? That's why you need the word of God. Paul said, take on the full armor of God. Belt represents your truth. When you fight the devil, you don't need a gun or lingan marama. You don't need a hand to punch. No. You need to be truthful, faithful. Because the devil is a liar. See? That's why you need the word of God. Breastplate of righteousness. Because the devil is very envy and jealous. Take on your shoes, or put on the shoes of the gospel of peace. Because the devil always wants to fight. The devil always wants to divide. Praise the Lord. The Bible says, take on the helmet of salvation. The devil does not want you to live a good life. That's why marijuana comes in, sniffing glue comes in. The devil always wants you to have a short life. So it's a self-destruction. Drink, cover, smoke, alcohol. See? All the things that damage the temple of God. See, the devil always fight on the opposite of God. So increasing the police force will not help the problem. But the word of God will tell you, come away from evil thing. That's the word of God. That's why we visit all the schools that they can assist us in coming and share with you. Some of you that you are sitting here, you are doing exactly what I'm sharing today. Some of you boys that you are smoking. Some of you boys, you are sniffing glue. Some of you boys, if they put you into prison, you come back, you sniff glue again. But if you receive Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, and the Holy Spirit will tell you that you are the temple of the Holy Spirit, you will never smoke again. I used to be a heavy smoker. Me. You give me one BH20, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock, will maybe one roll left. I was a heavy smoker. See, I have degree, I am educated, just like your teachers. I work in the control tower. I speak to pilots. Oh, very nice, eh? Big money. But I was a heavy smoker. I look good outside. See? But I'm doing evil thing inside. My degree does not tell me evil and good. That's why the word of God will tell you. When you talk about thy word is a lamp, gives you light. See? Thy word is a lamp to your feet and a light to your path. It makes you look at yourself properly. I was sitting there
smoking away. Maybe every hour I'll have 2-3 rolls. And if the pressure is big, a lot of airplane coming and you talk a lot, and maybe it's an ABC, we're going to cover you. I go to church in Nazareth, in Namaka, Tamadadava Namaka. I become a lay preacher. And one day I was reading my Bible. Don't you know that your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit? Whoa! Hey! See? My degree does not tell me that my body is the temple of the Holy Spirit. The Bible tells me. Listen, hang on. If I'm the temple of the Holy Spirit, I'm better than the church. Because I don't smoke in church. I don't drink cover in church. I don't swear in church. And why I'm smoking in my body? Why I'm abusing my body? Then I am the temple of God. The church is not the temple of God. The church is the place of worship. So I'm better than the church. You are better than the church. You are created by God. The church is built by men. The Bible says, what house, what mansion you prepare for me? Don't you know that heaven is my place and the earth is my footstool? What mansion you prepare for me? I only esteem, O Molebanga, I only esteem the one who have a broken in their spirit, contrite in their heart, and fear my word. I don't go to those that go to church. I don't stay in the preachers and tal-tal. No. I stay with those that fear my word. That's my temple. That word of God changed my life. 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 17, 18, 19. 1 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 15, 14, 14, 15, 16, and 17. Then Paul said, you are the temple of God, and the Spirit of God lives in you. And those that will destroy the temple of God, then God will destroy them. That's when I throw away the things that I used to do. Because nobody tells me. I never heard a preacher that tells me, don't smoke, don't drink kava, don't drink alcohol. I never heard a preacher. I read it in the Bible. So when I read it in the Bible, then I realized, oh, that means everything that we do through our body, swearing, that's from the devil. Stealing, that's from the devil. Fighting, finger pointing, gossip, slander, that's all from the devil. It's not from the world. And if it's from the devil, we have to attack it by using the word of God. And I believe to minimize, to challenge any boys that you are here, you disobedient to your parents, you disobedient to your teachers, that is the work of the devil. The temor, if I can't get you, may I any no nabakatal? Do we have to be a bakatal and a temor? Pick the gibo. Karangatos, are we going to bakatal? You are the toy of the devil. I think no one sitting here wants to be the toy of the devil. Amen? We want to be the vessel of the Holy Spirit. Okay, if the Holy Spirit wants to do something, He can use your life. I want the Holy Spirit to use my life. And if the word of God to be spread out to the people, He will look for a vessel. He will look for someone. And are you a vessel of honor, a vessel of God, or are you a vessel of the devil? We can put it in such a way. Are you a vessel of God, or are you the tools of the devil? Which one? If you swear, that means you are the tool of the devil.